بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. We continue reading and translating and explaining from the book called Azamat al-Islam, The Greatness of Islam, by Sheikh Mahmoud Mahdi al-Istanbuli. Why we reading this book? Because the more that we learn about the greatness of our deen, the more that we hold fast to it, the more that we sacrifice for it, the more that we try to preach it and teach it and give da'wah to others. Because when you value something, this when you be concerned about it. I gave the example before, like somebody having a ring out of silver as example, and somebody have a ring that made out of gold and have precious stones in it. The person who have a ring that is gold with a lot of precious stones in it, he will guard it more, watch for it more, and take care of it more. Why? Because the value of it. The more that we know about our deen, the more we love it, the more that we hold fast to it, the more that we willing to make any sacrifice for it by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the greatness of Islam that give a complete and a full picture and correct picture concerning the Creator Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not a fuzzy picture. It's so crystal and clear. There is a big difference between somebody saying that God is the mother nature, or God is a black man, or God is a man on the cross. When you read about the aqidah and the belief and the knowledge related to Allah and who is Allah, who is the God and the only God, Allah, you could not find any other ideology can be comparative to Islam when it comes about talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Something clear, something strong, is something meets with the nature of the human being, and it make a lot of sense. As example, when we talk about the oneness of Allah, is not one in three or three in one. He is not that God that is defeated or that he's wrestling with somebody. He is one and he is unique. He's the first without beginning. He's the last without end, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The drawing a picture or giving the proper understanding about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of the uniqueness and the cornerstone of this deen. talks about the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perfect and complete, no deficiency in it, no any crookedness in it, a full and clear, strong, and it is easy and simple to understand. And also, it invites the believers to have some impact of this quality and characteristic of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a sense, if you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is as-sabur, that's also for us to learn to be having patience and having sabr. From the sabr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that being sabur and being afu, his patience and forbearing and forgiving all this million of people who claim that he has a son, he's still feeding them and giving them to drink and giving them more life that they may repent. So power, mighty, and also forbearing and forgiveness. And we need to learn the same thing. To try to carry this in our daily life when we deal with the people, when we deal with our families, or even dealing with ourselves. And this is bring a special unique feeling in the personality of the believers. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in surah number 8, verse number 2, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Indeed, the believers are the ones that when Allah's name is mentioned, their hearts gets full with fear. And when the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recited on them, it will increase them in faith. And they put their trust in Allah. So when people fear, the believers, they don't fear. When the people run away, the believers, they don't run away. Why? Because they know who is their ilah, who is their God. And anything to fear or to make them shaky, right away when they remember Allah, their hearts comes full with iman and it strengthens them and makes them to be sure and firm. They don't run away when the people run away. They don't get scared when people try to scare them. And when they hear the verses of Allah, it increases them in iman. It gives them a reminder. And they put their trust in Allah, not in the people, not in anything else. Not in the people, not in the material thing. Let's look to Qarun as example. إن قارون كان من قوم موسى. قارون was one of the people of the Prophet Moses, the community of the Prophet موسى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him so much wealth, so much wealth. Okay? To such a degree that he say, إنما أوتيتو على علم عندي. I've been given this because I'm smart, because I'm knowledgeable. I know how to make the dollar. I know how to get the money, okay? And Allah told us how much millionaire or billionaire was Qarun. It's not like the dumb, or whatever you call him, Trump, dumb, whatever the name is. Allah saying, وَإِنَّ مَفَاتِحُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُلُقُوَّةِ. The keys, only the keys to open the treasures, a group of people have to come together to be able to carry the keys. If the keys is so much and so heavy that I need a group of people to carry it, can you imagine the wealth that inside the treasures. But when he did not submit to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. Allah made the earth open and swallow him. Him as well as his treasures. فما كان له من فئة ينصرونه من دون الله وما كان من المنتصرين. He did not have any support or any helper. Because if Allah doesn't give you support or help, nobody can help you. So people, they feel because they have weapons, they have army, they have a chair, they have ruling, that they can do everything. The mighty and power is in their hands. But the believers always believe what? لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. That there is no power or mighty except by Allah. So the uniqueness of this Islam, it fills your heart with strength. You don't get fear. Okay? And you put in your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has control over everything. Nothing has control of Allah. Not the mother nature, not the superpower, nothing. Okay? Many nations, before China and America and Russia and all these things, they used to be nations. Thamud, Ad, Fir'aun Zil Autad. This is not the first time that people has power in the earth. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying what? فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْتَ عَذَابٍ. All these things, you understand, is nothing but mirage. And the Iman is the only one who will open your eyes, strengthen yourself and your heart, and make you firm. As a result of this, you find that the believers, they love Allah so much. Okay? They love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much. As we stated last week, the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. Among the people, they took partners beside Allah. They love them equal to their love to Allah. But the believers, more love. They love Allah more. Okay? The kuffar, they have partners. And they have many things besides their God they love. But the love of the believers to Allah more greater than the love of the kuffar to their things. This Islam, it's a beauty when it gives the correct understanding about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, it gives you a protection. What kind of protection, organization, that you don't think about Allah, but think and reflect in His creation? Because Allah is unique. There is nothing similar to Allah. So you try to think about Allah, you believe in Allah as Allah telling you who is He. But how we could not reach to realization how is Allah is. But Allah exists. Allah is the creator. Allah self-sufficient. As example, we don't say, how does Allah live? Because Allah has a life, and the life of Allah is different from our life. Everything Allah sees, we see. But you could not compare this. So now, the frame of your Iman, do not think about how when it comes about Allah. Okay? You say you understand when the people or describe to you how do you see, and you see things, and inside there is lights come or go out of your lights, eyes, and you see things, and the picture comes upside down in your eye, and after this you see it up straight and things like this, okay? And your vision can be 20/20, or can be less, or can be more, or you can have magnified glass. You're going to see. They're giving you all this explanation. How do you see? And how the picture go in the back of your head, and after this is flipped down, and after this goes straight in your eyes, and you can see it. We read in the Quran, Allah Sami' and Basir. Allah is all hearing, all seeing. But how does Allah see? This is not your job. And this is beyond your ability, and the machineries, and the computers, and the labs, and all these things. So do not think how when it comes about Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ وهي دخان فقال لها وللأرض ائتيا طوعا أو كرها قالتا أتينا طائعين. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ascended to the heaven and said to, while it was a smoke, then Allah told the earth and the sky, come willingly or unwillingly. They said, oh Allah, we come willingly. Then Allah formed it to be seven earth and seven skies. How Allah ascended? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us that يتنزل ربنا تبارك وتعالى كل ليلة حين يكون ثلث الليل الأخير وينادي هل من مستغفر فأغفر له هل من سائل فأعطيه. Allah Almighty descend every night in the last part of the night, and Allah calls, is anyone making dua? I will answer his dua. Anybody seeking forgiveness? I give him forgiveness. Someone will sit down. How Allah goes up and down, how he move, does he travel, wings, is by aeroplane, or, no, you could not reach this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you see, you know things when there is a similarity. When somebody talk to you about keys, oh boy, all right, you see, you like this, huh? Yeah, I can see you watching it. Come on. What did it? Okay. Okay, we do it like this. We get rid of this. And we get this out and put this back again. All right? Always there is a way, many ways to skin the cat. I was going to say the goat. Anyway, you see, car key and house key, there is some kind of similarity, but there is more teeth here and more grave here and more this. And this. There is something called similarity, all right? But the only one that there is no similarity is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you could not compare. You could not compare things. So you know something and you describe something when you see it physically, or there is a similarity. So no one saw Allah, okay? No one saw Allah, neither there is a similarity for Allah. Therefore, you believe in Allah as He is, without saying how. This is the way to be safe. This is the way you be secure. You feel it in your heart, okay? You can see in His creation, but see His power. He telling us that He raised the heaven without a pillar that you see. That means there is pillars holding the sky, but we could not see it. Or that the sky is lifted up with no pillars, period. You understand? So, you see the power of Allah. You see the power of Allah when you put a seed on the ground. Doesn't matter, you put it this way, or that way. The roots will go down, and the leaves and the branches will go up. Is this a computer chip inside the seed? No. But there is a power of Almighty Allah. There's the ability of Allah. So think about what you see from the creation of Allah, but do not think about Allah how. How doesn't apply to Allah? Because we are limited in our vision. We could not see Allah, but Allah will make it as a prize and a gift for us in the day of judgment. for the believers to see Allah. But here we are limited. As example, if I ask any one of you, tell me the color of this car that just passing in Gervais Street. No one can tell me. Not because we are blind, but because you don't have the ability. There is something here will block your vision, the wall. You see? But in the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us a different ability that we can see Allah and we can enjoy looking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ In that day, faces will be brightened because they look to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what's Islam give us in this dunya? Characteristic of Allah, quality of Allah, names of Allah, and for you to see the ability of Allah in things. How he make the rain comes, how he make you understand the roots go down, how he make you understand all these trees, how he make all these oceans, how he, these things, you can think about it. But for you to try to draw a picture in your mind about Allah's hearing or Allah's sight, this is no, because there is no similarity and no one can see Allah in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran in Surah number 6, verse 103, لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار. Vision could not reach him, but he reaches our vision. Okay? We could not see Allah, but Allah sees us. All right? لا تدركه الأبصار. The Absar, the vision, the eyes could not see him, but he see us. Okay? And also he's telling us, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. You are not being given from the knowledge except a little. A little. All the knowledge of the people of all mankind, if you put it together, okay, it doesn't come to even one hair in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know things when it happened. We did not see it. We did not describe until we can see it, we can tell such a thing, okay? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his knowledge is totally different. He knows things before its existence, okay? Not the past, the present, the future. So everything, when it comes, so Allah telling us we need to learn our limit. And our limit is telling us what you've been given from the knowledge is nothing but a little. But He Almighty is Al-Alim Al-Khabir. Okay? And for us to learn, we need tools. We need schools, we need teachers, we need to observe, we need to touch. But Allah doesn't need all these things. You see? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِهِ عِلْمًا. He knows what precedes them, their past, their future. And no one can encompass Allah. You know things. Certain things about Allah. But even by knowing things about Allah, you could not make an imagination in your mind. The word even Allah, which is Al-Ilah, okay, and the two lambs have been merged together, became Allah. The one that minds could not reach his could not reach his real essence. No way. Your mind is limited. Your mind is limited. So Allah is the one that minds could not imagine him and they stay wonder. How much you think you're going to continue in wonder? Because you could not really get to the real essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know things about Allah, but you know names, you know qualities, but the essence itself, you could not know it. You could not reach it. Why? Because Allah said, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. You are not been given from knowledge anything except little. As a result of this, the safety of a human being to think about Allah's creation, not the creator. Okay? Not the creator. Think about the creation. Take the leaves. Take the hand of a lizard or a frog or even a roach and examine it. Okay? You can see amazing things. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make like a suction cups in their feet, how they can climb, how they can stick to a wall. Things even we could not do it. Okay? But how Allah created these things. This is what you can think. And when you see it, say, Subhanallah. Glory be to Allah. Amazing, the work of Allah. But when it comes about Allah, they say, you are as you are. You are as you are. You know about yourself more than anyone else. And no one can figure you more than you. Okay? So we praise him in a manner that fit his majesty, because we could not even praise him in the proper way, because him deserve more than what we saying. So we say we praise you in a manner that make you please and fits your majesty. But if we stay day and night saying Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, we could not even scratch the surface of praising him or talking good about him. Okay? The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had told us in the hadith, which is the meaning is, people will continue questioning, asking about Allah. لا يزال الناس يتساءلون حتى يقول قائلهم هذا الله خلق الخلق فمن خلق الله. Subhanallah. This hadith 1400-1500 years ago. Okay? But now we got to see the hadith. We see it in our society in different places. The people will come times, the Prophet said, will come times that the people say, this is the creation of God. Okay? God creates the tree, God creates the mountain, God created this and that. But who created God? Did the time come? Did anybody hear these things?
Yes.
People start to talk about things like this, okay? Was not exist. People used to be some Jews, some Christian, okay? They may be committing shirk. The worst things that you hear in the history, people committing shirk. That means they believe in God and that there is like somebody, wasita, connection between you and God to bring you closer to God. In Jesus' name, as example, okay? So believe in God, and they believe in Jesus, and Jesus only like a mediator between you and God. But about ilhad, or person to deny creator, this was not known, okay? You barely can hear it in any nations before. But the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that will come time, the people will say, this is the creation of God. This is this, this that, but who created God? The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying, فَمَنْ وَجَدَ مِنْ ذَٰلِكَ شَيْءٍ قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فَلْيَسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ وَلْيَنْتَهِ. Whosoever feels any thoughts like this, let him stop and seek refuge in Allah from the shaitan. Because this is whispering of the shaitan. Creator has no creator. Creator, there is only one creator, and he created everything. He's the first without beginning, he's the last without end. He knows the future and the past, same to him. Okay? So the Prophet ﷺ had told us about the reality and what's going to happen. Therefore, the safety of the Muslim to fill his love, his heart with the love of Allah, the greatness of Allah, and to think about the creation of Allah, which is proving that there is God. But how to draw an image of God in mind, this not part of the Islam. And anything comes to your mind about how Allah looks, Allah is different from it. Anything comes to your mind about how Allah is, that Allah is different from what you're thinking. You see, we are 20 people sitting here. If everybody have a different thoughts, okay, about how God is, or how Almighty Allah is supposed to be, or how He hears and how He speak. Allah said in Quran, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. Allah spoke with Moses directly. And Moses heard him. And Musa, when he heard him, he loved it so much. And now he want to get to taste more, so he can get more closer. قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ إِلَيْكَ. After this seclusion, 40 days, worshiping, devotion to Allah, and Allah spoke with him. Now, Musa getting more excited. He get, okay, can I see you now? Say, not now, okay? قال لن تراني. You could not, he did not say, I'm not to be seen, but he say, you could not. We are not prepared for it, okay? He say, لن تراني ولكن انظر إلى الجبل فإن استقر مكانه فسوف تراني. Say, oh Allah, because he heard him. He spoke with Allah. He heard. Or somebody said, but, so Allah speak? Yes, Allah speak. Allah, وكلم الله موسى تكليما. Musa heard him, yes. So Allah has a tongue. Allah did not tell me anything about tongue. Allah said he spoke to him. How? I don't know. Did Musa hear him? And he heard the word. And he said, Innani ana Allahu la ilaha illa ana fa'budni. Indeed, I am Allah. That there is no other God other than me. So worship me alone. And establish the prayer for my remembrance. Okay? So Musa heard. So somebody say, okay, when we talk and we have lips, and if you understand, you have something with your tongue, this is you. But Allah is totally different from anything you think about it. So when Moses said, oh Allah, let me look at you, he said, you could not see me. So the problem is with us, not with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, okay? But Allah will change this later on in the day of judgment for the believers. They will be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said, you could not. That means physically, mentally, everything, you could not, Musa. And Musa was a strong man. You know, when he went and they tried to give water to the ladies, you understand, they're waiting. They don't want to go and mix with these men. They're waiting until they finish watering their folk. He was so strong. You know that when he kills a man, he didn't mean to kill him. But Musa, all what he did, he pushed him away, you understand? And only by putting his hand, pushing like this, he killed him. He was so strong. But Allah told him, look to the mountain. Musa, you could not see me. Although he's a strong man, but Allah said, you could not see me. But I will reflect or shine towards the mountain. If the mountain remain in its place, you will be able to see me. So who more strong, Musa or something, rocks, mountain. فَلَمَّا تَجَلَّ رَبُّهُ إِلَى الْجَبَلِ جَعَلَهُ دَكَّ وَخَرَّ مُوسَى صَعِقًا. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with only reflection of Allah's lights on towards the mountain, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, حِجَابُهُ النُّورِ. The veil between us and Allah is light. If Allah remove it, anything else on the creation will be burned. We talk about stars thousands and thousands of years all the way, and we can see this light and the sun, how far it is. And if it comes down 1 degree, it can burn it. He say, حِجَابُهُ النُّورِ, subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a veil Okay, that we could not see. If Allah removes this veil, everything that reach, it will be burned. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after this, He reflected on the mountain, and the mountain turned to dust. Okay, the mountain was not there anymore. And Musa fell, fainted, okay? And later on, he got back to his conscious. When he woke up, okay? فَلَمَّا فَقَ قَالَ So when he got back again to his conscious, okay? He seek Allah's forgiveness for asking Allah such a thing that is not supposed to be asked. So the safety of us in this life, that we reflect on Allah's creation, Allah's attributes, Allah's names, love Him, try to please Him, get closer to Him as much as we can, okay? But not to question or try to draw an image in our mind about Allah or His qualities. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all and keep us on the Sirat al-Mustaqim and give us, inshallah, His forgiveness and His mercy in this life and in the hereafter. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen and Allah knows best. Comments, correction, wa iyakum. Yes.
I was listening to something about saying that the Prophet Sallam, it was a janazah, and he had told one of the Sahabas to pray janazah, and he walked away. Can you, is that clear enough for you to know the situation, or I don't know if I explained enough for you. That's what I remember.
I didn't know that I talked about janazah this morning. Maybe I was sleeping. Was a person that he owned money, okay? Was a person that he owned money. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to, before he pray the janazah, he asked, is the man own anybody money? Okay? So, because he told us, the shaheed, the martyrs, all his sins will be forgiven with exception of the debt. Okay? To show you the seriousness of the matter. So, the man, they said, when they say, oh Prophet of Allah, he owns some money such and such, he will ask anybody willing to pay in his behalf. If so, it's fine. If not, okay, he did not pray. But does not mean that this person is not Muslim anymore. That means the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam have a special position, prestige, okay, for him to pray on somebody, this forgiveness. So he will say, understand, because the person, he commit a sin, or as example, he kill himself, commit suicide, he will say to the Sahaba, what? Pray in your brother. So it's a way of showing you disapproval of certain action in Islam, but does not mean that the person, no one pray in him, but the leader himself, he is not praying on him, and he will delegate this to somebody else. Is this what you're asking about? Inshallah. Wafika barak. Any question? No, you have a question? I like your hat. Can I take a... I'm collecting picture for all these hats. We have competition about hats this morning. Where is mine? Oh, I think mine will do the best. But when it goes outside in the cold, then يتمدد بالحرارة وينكمش بالبرودة. How you say this in English? It'll extend it with heat and shrink with cold. Do you know what this? It's something that we study in science, that like metal, when you put heat on it, expand, yes, okay? And after this, it shrink when it gets cold. So yeah, my hat is not like all these hats. Okay, but mine, because we in the cold, what you call shrink, okay, but inshallah when we go outside in the sun will be almost like All right, we're going to close our question and answer. 2, 3, number 4, we close. No question, no comments.
I have a question.
About the subject?
No. Okay. Not on this subject.
Yeah?
Not on what you read.
Oh, yeah, the other side?
No, no.
Okay, go ahead.
I have a question like regarding payment of medical bills using that thing, payment plan or something.
Uh-huh.
Is that allowed interest? I mean, is this allowed in Islam? I mean, if they, because here they send a big bill and I don't have the money to pay. But okay. I understand that if I make a payment plan, it has, I think it has interest or something like this,
mm-hmm.
the same thing, contract or something.
Okay.
So my question is, what is...
لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah doesn't burden any soul beyond its capacity. So if it's your capacity that you pay $50 every month, okay, otherwise you go rob a bank to pay them, it's no. You're talking about 5,000, 10,000, 20,000. Okay, sometimes you go in the hospital, you stay for an hour, you understand he comes with a bill. Every minute there was about $1,000. So you don't have the means. So you have no other choice except to be paying $20 a month or $20 a week, whatever it is. They gain, they take an interest. You're hating this in your heart, you did not give it willingly, so you have no choice. And same time that you try to pay your debt. So when became usury that you for luxury of this life and you consent to it, now the haram will be also you be involved in it. But something beyond your ability, inshallah, you are forgiven. All right. Anybody else? Okay, we're going to hit the button and start our meeting, inshallah.